Change in Art and Architecture. Art and architecture reflects the thoughts and customs of the society which produces them. Right from ancient times, there has been a fusion of indigenous and foreign influences that have shaped the course of arts in India. In early period, most of the arts were derived with Vedic influences. Gradually, arts flourished under the patronage of kings and emperors. The coming of Islam generated a whole new era of Indian architecture and art. Finally, the British brought their own Gothic and Roman influences and merged it with Indian style. Painting. Under the Mughals, miniature painting was the major art form. Thus, by 18th century, many regional miniature schools existed. After the governance of India was taken over by the British monarchy, Mughals ceased to be the driving force behind Indian art. The 19th century marked the introduction of easel painting and oil paints to India. Brought by European artists, this type of painting was later taught at schools. Several academies were opened in Bombay, Mumbai, Madras, Chennai, and Calcutta, Kolkata. The mid-19th century saw the birth of art schools in various parts of the country. The artists created new trends by fusing Renaissance and contemporary neoclassical styles together. Traditional Indian painting slowly began to be influenced by European themes and techniques. Many British artists began to work in India. For example, Tilly Kettle, a British painter, worked for the Nawab of Awadh. Raja Rajendra Malik of Bengal engaged European artists to produce his family portraits. Formal art education in India started with the establishment of the Mechanical Institute in Calcutta in 1839. A new school of painting called Company School, named after British East India Company, emerged. The school evolved in response to the demand for paintings of Indian people, scenes and monuments amongst the British officials and their families in India. A new school of painting called the Bengal School was founded by Abanindranath Tagore. He came up with the best known painting, Bharat Mata, Mother India, depicting a young woman portrayed with four arms in the manner of Hindu deities, upholding objects symbolic of India's national aspirations. Rabindranath Tagore was one of the most famous Indian painters. His Vishwa Bharati at Shantiniketan near Kolkata served as one of the main centers for Bengal School of Painting. Paintings by Nandalal Bose portray scenes from Indian mythology and the everyday life of artists and craftsmen. Amrita Shergill depicted the lives of common people. Hindu themes, royal portraits and court scenes were common themes. Raja Ravi Varma was an important painter in South India. Many of his life-like paintings feature Hindu gods and goddesses and mythological stories. Another tradition of art that became popular in colonial India was portrait painting. Unlike the existing Indian tradition of painting portraits in miniature, colonial portraits were life-size images that looked real. The size of the painting itself projected the importance of the patrons who commissioned these portraits. This new style of portraiture also served as an ideal means of displaying the lavish lifestyles, wealth and status that the empire generated. Many of the Indian Nawabs too began commissioning imposing oil portraits by European painters. Undermining the power of kings, some of the Nawabs reacted against the interference, others accepted the political and cultural superiority of British. They hoped to socialize with the British and adopt their style and taste. There was another category of imperial art called history painting. This tradition sought to dramatize and recreate various episodes of British imperial history and enjoyed great prestige and popularity during late 18th and early 19th century.